Hello dear traders, it's Petko Aleksandrov speaking from EA Forex Academy, and today I will talk about some of the recent updates that we have with the EA Studio Strategy Builder. So there are some changes in the interface. For example, we have the first page now says Home, and it's not EA Studio as it was before. Now, if we look at this blue bar on the top, we have the data. So before, the data was in tools right over here in the menu. Now it is on the top, and it is much easier to find it right over here, because it's very important when you create your own strategies using EA Studio to create it with the data from your broker. So it's very easy to access to it. Just click over it and you will see it right in front of you. Now, what is new about the Forex Data Import? First, you can notice all the data on the right side that you have imported from the brokers that you have been using. Then we have the data horizon, and the data horizon looks just the same. And there is a slight difference here that the maximum data bars, but this is only for the licensed users, is up to 500,000 bars. Okay, I don't know if this will last, but before the maximum was 200,000 and now it is 500,000. But once again, this is for the licensed users only. And if you wish to try that, if you are already a licensed user of EA Studio, you will need as well to modify the script for exporting the data. And if I go to the data import, right here are the scripts. And once you download one of them, depending if you use MetaTrader 4 or you use MetaTrader 5, you need to drop it on your platform right over here. For the people who didn't do it so far, you need to go to File, Open Data Folder, and then you go to MQL4 and you go to Script. So this is where you need to paste it. After that, you need to refresh the scripts and you will see it below over here. Now, what you need to do if you want to increase the number of bars that you will be exporting, right mouse and you go to modify. This way you will open the meta editor, and here are the maximum bars. So you will need to enter 500,000 and you compile it and it will be saved. So if I close the meta editor and I drop the script over the chart, you will see actually there will be 500,000 bars to export. And this is quite a lot of data. Not all the brokers will provide you with such data. You will probably need to collect it long time, and with the higher time frames you will actually never get this data, but with the lower time frames you might have such a huge data if you are interested to try it out. Once again, I'm not sure how long it will last, if they will keep it from the Forex software company. Alright, then what we have is the data statistics. This is something new over here. We have statistics for the data. Now, let's load some data, meaning that I will go to the strategy and I will just change a couple of time frames. For example, let's go down to M15 and let's choose some of the data that I have. For example, from the Pepperstone demo server. Absolutely, this strategy started to lose because it was for the euro dollar and I just changed it to Bitcoin and Ethereum. So let's have some data that I have for Forex. With Pepperstone, Demo02 has some Forex pair. And as well, I will go to GFD demo data and I will go to euro dollar. So here on M15, you see the strategy is losing. I will go to M30 and I will go to H1. This is where originally this strategy was created, so you can see better results. Now, if I go back to data, you will see in data statistics that I have already many loaded files. So all the servers that I have switched in the strategy, they are shown now in the data statistics. So what we have the market information about this broker, about the asset and about the time frame. So you can see the specifications that we see normally in MetaTrader, and then we have statistics for the data. This is something very, very useful. At first we have the minimum price, and then we have the maximum price for this period that we have for euro dollar on H1. Then we have average gap, 2 points, which is pretty normal for Forex data. Then we have maximum gap, which you can see here is 200 pips, nearly 2000 points, which is 200 pips. Well, I cannot really say what's going on here, because for H1 it's not really normal to have such a gap. Maybe it is something between Friday and Monday, but 200 pips is really a lot. Now, average high low, we have here 17.1 pips, maximum high low, we have 250 pips, then average close open 8 pips, and then maximum close open 229 pips or 2290 points. Now, here is very interesting, maximum days off, meaning that the market was not open for some reason. And as you know, market is open from Monday to Friday with some of the brokers on Sunday, and there are some exceptional cases around holidays, but you should normally not see more than 3 days, 2, 3, 4 days. If there are more, you will probably need to recheck your data and see, because probably there is some missing information or some missing period. And I noticed such a thing. I will just check around the loaded files that I have. So let's go to the dollar yen on GFD on M15. Yeah, you can see maximum days of 41 days. So there is something here with the data on M15. There is some missing period with 41 days. This is more than 1 month. And from these statistics, I can see that there is some data actually missing for this period of time. Now you can see the average gap here is 1 point, which is just great. And then you can see the average high low, the maximum high low, and the other statistics. So this way you can check your data once you upload it, okay, once you export it first from the MetaTrader, and then you drop the files here, and you can check if your data is all right, because till now we didn't have this statistic and there was no way to understand if there is something wrong with our data. For example, what I have shown on dollar yen on M15, that there are 41 days off. One more time, this is a missing period in the data, so I need to recheck it or to re-export it one more time. All right, so this statistic is really, really great update. We can check if our data is proper and we can use it. But here as well, I noticed that the maximum gap is 5,936 points, which is 593 pips as well. Very unusual, especially for M15. And I guess this is from the missing period in the data. So imagine there is data from one day to another, then there is 41 days missing data, and then this data continues, which will form a gap. Let me demonstrate it to you very quickly. Let's say this is the historical data or the price chart. I will just go randomly, and then we have data for this period of time. And then we have some missing data, in this case is 41 days. So the program will recognize it like this, okay? It will continue on different price and it will continue. So this thing here, the program will recognize it as missing period and it will consider it as a gap, because simply there is no information for this period. In this case, it's for this 41 days. All right, I really hope that it makes it clearer. So once you drop your data, make sure to check the maximum days off, very, very important, and as well the maximum gap and average gap. But if you have missing days in your data, most probably you will have a huge maximum gap. Because one more time, this is a data that is missing and the program, the EA Studio, recognize it as a gap. One thing more here, we have this release data button. So if I click on it, you will see I will clear all these data because it was saved on the computer and I would just want to remove it. Or what you can do as well is to reload the page, which will remove these loaded files. So how they come here, once again, if you go to your strategy, no matter which strategy, and you just switch between any of the servers that you have or the historical data that you have from the different brokers, and you switch between different assets and time frames. So let's go for the Ethereum. I will go to all time frames and you will see that it will show in data statistics all these time frames over here. And by clicking on each one, I can see the statistics. And here you can see pretty good data for the Ethereum because it has 3 days on M5. It has these 9 days on M1. Something is missing there, about 1 month. But on the higher time frames, it is just fine. So with this quick check, I know that there is no missing data with this broker with all time frames, except on M1, which is nearly 1 month, and with Ethereum, and on M5, which is about 9 days. But anyway, I don't trade the cryptocurrencies on such low time frame as M1 and M5. But one more time, I wouldn't know that if the statistic is not here. Very useful, and it's the only way actually you can understand if your historical data that you have exported from your broker is working fine. This is about the data update in EA Studio. And one more thing here, we have the language bar moved to the home page right over here. So if you wish to actually edit the software somewhere between these languages, or you can translate it in totally different language, drop an email and we will explain you more. Actually, there are some benefits if you want to translate or help editing the language in EA Studio. Thank you very much for watching. This is Petko Aleksandrov. Have safe trading. Cheers.